What's up with this bridge? It looks photoshopped, or else it would be a major disaster. But the bridges in this video are real and really are some of the biggest in the world.
Number 15, Akashi Kaikyo Bridge. This massive suspension bridge connects the city of Kobe, yes, the namesake for Kobe beef as well as Kobe Bryant, with Awaji Island. It's got the longest central span in the world, with 2 kilometers or 6,500 feet between the two main towers. It's a big part of the massive Honshu Shikoku Bridge project, connecting the largest Japanese island, Honshu, with the smallest of the four main islands, Shikoku. Construction took 10 years between 1988 and 1998 and was delayed by a massive earthquake in 1995.
The Great Hanshin earthquake moved the towers so much that an extra meter had to be added into the plans halfway through construction.
It was designed to be able to withstand future earthquakes, though, up to an 8.5 on the Richter scale. It can also expand by up to 2 meters from heat over the course of a day. At $3.6 billion to construct, it had better be able to withstand shocks like that. Number 14. Milau Viaduct.
This is the tallest bridge in the world.
It sits a stunning 1,100 feet, or 336 meters above the ground below, crossing the gorge valley of the River Tarn in southern France. The bridge cost about $500 million and links Paris to points south. Surprisingly, it only took 3 years to build and opened in 2004. It's been ranked as one of the greatest engineering achievements of all time, with the highest pylons in the world. That's right, one of these bad boys is a terrifying 245 meters high, or over 800 feet. Designed to last 120 years, if you are driving from Paris to Spain, you almost certainly will want to cross over this monument to human ingenuity. Number 13, Duge Bridge. This is the highest bridge in the world, not to be confused with the tallest. What's the difference? The Milau Viaduct has a high structural height with its massive pylons. This bridge, crossing the deep river gorge, has towers only 880 feet tall, but the deck of the bridge is over 1,800 feet above the river below. So it's actually the Duge Bridge that gets the honor of the highest. Built recently, from 2011 to 2016, this bridge cuts the travel time from Yunnan and Guizhou, two remote provinces in south-central China, down from 4 hours to a single hour.
China has invested tons of money and time into building these impressive bridges throughout their hinterlands.
They have now built 8 of the 10 highest bridges in the world. Number 12, Eshima Ohashi Bridge. This is the scary bridge that has photos circulating the internet. The grade appears intense when depicted with a special telephoto lens, though it's actually a normal 5.1% gradient on one side and a 6.1% gradient on the other.
It's really not that scary to drive over.
This is a rigid frame bridge, the largest in Japan, connecting the cities of Matsue and Sakai Minato. It's a comparatively small 1.7 kilometers, or about 1 mile. But for a rigid frame where the whole bridge is a single unit of building material, it would be difficult to make a bridge that crosses larger spans. Thanks to the miracle of pre-stressed concrete, this bridge can exist and continue to terrify and alarm the internet for years to come. Number 11, Mike O'Callaghan, Pat Tillman Memorial Bridge. This famous bridge spans the Colorado River right after the Hoover Dam, connecting Arizona and Nevada. It was opened in 2010 and replaced a road that went over the dam directly, making the crossing much safer. Named after O'Callaghan, a former governor of Nevada and a deceased U.S. soldier, Pat Tillman, it is the world's highest concrete arch bridge, 890 feet above the Colorado River. It's a big part of the Interstate 11 project, which aims to link southwestern cities of Phoenix and Las Vegas all the way up to Reno with a major interstate highway. How did they do it? They hoisted workers up with a high-line crane system to sit and build the span using massive steel cables.
High winds posed insane risks, but today, this bridge is known as an American triumph.
Number 10, Manchac Swamp Bridge. The first of three bridges on this list in the state of Louisiana, the Manchac Swamp Bridge is the longest bridge on the United States interstate highway system. It's also been called the longest toll-free road bridge in the world. It's made of concrete piles that got driven 250 feet below the bottom of the swamp that it crosses and goes across water for over 22 miles, or 37 kilometers. Incredible. It first opened in 1979 at a cost of $150 million, but it is a critical part of the North-South Interstate 55 and connects New Orleans with points north.
For a state half submerged in the Mississippi River and the Gulf of Mexico, it makes sense that Louisiana needs all the big bridges it can get.
Number 9, Atchafalaya Basin Bridge. This bridge carries Interstate 10 across the Atchafalaya Basin in Louisiana, between Baton Rouge and Lafayette. It's 18.2 miles long and was first built in 1971. When it was built, it was the biggest in the United States and even contains two highway exits from the bridge itself. Unfortunately, the bridge is prone to accidents because there are portions of the bridge that are narrow and do not have shoulders. Because the area doesn't have many residents, this can cause major traffic delays to get the vehicles removed.
With over 30,000 vehicles crossing this bridge every day, a new lower speed limit had to be placed on it, and recently new traffic laws were also enforced in order to reduce risk.
Number 8, Mackinac Bridge. This incredible suspension bridge spans the upper and lower peninsulas of Michigan and is a full 5 miles, or 8 kilometers, of impressive engineering. It was fully built in 1957, nearly 80 years after engineers first tried to design the original plans. When completed, it was the world's longest suspension bridge between anchorages, which meant that, compared to the Golden Gate Bridge, it was slightly longer overall. Even compared to the mighty Akashi Kaikyo, the Mackinac Bridge has a longer shoreline-to-shoreline length today. After the Brooklyn Bridge was built in 1883, enthusiasts and engineers tried to get plans going to create a bridge across the Straits of Mackinac, which connects Lake Michigan and Lake Huron. But the idea took years before the government made formal movement towards getting a bridge built, and even then, construction took $100 million, 4 years, and the lives of 5 workers.
Nowadays, even painting the bridge is a 7-year endeavor, and just when the work crews finish, they start over from the other side again.
Number 7, 7 Mile Bridge. You know the Florida Keys? The string of islands off the tip of Florida that extend into the Gulf of Mexico? Who wouldn't want to take a vacation down there?
Well, with the 7 Mile Bridge, you can actually drive over the open ocean and make it.
U.S. Highway 1, the longest north-south highway in the United States, extends all the way down from northern Maine to Key West, and the longest bridge portion of it is the 7 Mile Bridge. It was one of the longest in the world when first built, going over open ocean in the Gulf. Partially destroyed in the Labor Day hurricane of 1935, the government refurbished the old railroad bridge, widened it for cars, and now carries traffic, water, and fiber optic cables to Key West. And yes, the bridge is about 7 miles long, though a second, newer span was built in the early 1980s that is only 6.8 miles. Number 6, Weinan Weihe Grand Bridge. This bridge is pretty impressive as well. It's nearly 50 miles or 80 kilometers long and connects Zhengzhou and Xi'an, two major cities deep in central northern China. When it was completed in 2008, it was the longest bridge in the world. It crosses the Wei River not once, but twice, and numerous other rivers and roads as well. This bridge was a major piece of revitalizing inland China's economy. Usually, it's the cities on the east coast of China that prosper, but deep in the high plains and mountains of central and western China, there are cities that require rail links to grow and trade with the rest of the world.
Weinan Weihe Grand Bridge is part of the Chinese government's plan to do just that.
Number 5, Tianjin Grand Bridge. This one is part of the Beijing-Shanghai High-Speed Railway and runs for over 70 miles, or 114 kilometers. Currently, it's the second longest bridge in the world, going between Langfang and Qingxian. Each of the 32-meter-long box girders used to make the bridge weighs 860 tons, and there are over 3,000 of them used in its construction.
That means that this bridge weighs over 3 million tons.
They needed special mobile work sites to build the pieces next to the bridge itself and used huge cranes to raise the girders on top of the pillars one by one. What a feat. Number 4. Danyang Kunshan Grand Bridge. It's not all over water, but this raised viaduct is technically the world's longest single bridge. How long? Over 100 miles or 165 kilometers. That's a very impressive span. It's also on the Beijing-Shanghai High-Speed Railway, which has transported over 200 million passengers.
This railway can bring people about 800 miles from one city to the other in about 4 hours. That's absolutely mind-boggling.
There are 244 bridges on the railway, and Danyang Kunshan is the biggest. How many people did it take to build this bridge? Over 10,000, along with 4 years and $8.5 billion. The open water section of the bridge across Yangcheng Lake is 9 kilometers long in and of itself. Number 3. Lake Pontchartrain Causeway. This bridge is so iconic, it's sometimes just called the Causeway. It crosses the famous Lake Pontchartrain in Louisiana, near New Orleans. Containing over 9,500 concrete pilings, the total span is over 38 kilometers, or 24 miles long. It connects Metairie and Mandeville, Louisiana, and it was listed as the longest bridge over water in the world. First built in 1956 and doubled with a second span in 1969, the whole bridge cost $30 million, which has been paid off by tolls for motorists crossing it.
Sorry, flat earthers, but this bridge is so long that a special telephoto lens can take a picture of it and expose the curvature of the bridge, which exposes the curvature of the earth.
Yes, this bridge, like much of New Orleans, was damaged during Hurricane Katrina in 2005, but it was up and back in commission soon after. The bridge didn't only lift the fortunes of people who live in small villages on the north shore of Lake Pontchartrain, it also showed that human engineering could cross insurmountable distances. Amazing. Number 2. Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel. Clocking in at over 17 miles, or 28 kilometers, the Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel is America's longest bridge tunnel system. It has been around for over 55 years and has been crossed by more than 130 million cars and trucks. As the name says, it crosses the edge of the Chesapeake Bay in Virginia on the Atlantic coast of the United States.
Prior to its opening, cars had to take a ferry to get from Virginia Beach to the eastern shore of the Chesapeake Bay.
During the construction of this monster, numerous storms and hurricanes hampered progress, including destroying a custom-built pile driver barge called the Big D. There were several times that skeptics thought the bridge would never be completed, but despite political battles and fights against nature, in 1964, the bridge opened up for traffic for the first time. Over the years, all the investors were paid off for their stake in the tunnel, and it has been expanded multiple times to allow two-way traffic along 4 lanes. This marvel of American engineering also incorporates multiple artificial islands to switch between bridges and tunnels and is a tourist attraction in and of itself.
These bridges are insane, real miracles of human achievement, but there's still one more to go. First, if you like this video, click subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and speak out in the comments. Have you ever been scared to drive across a bridge? There are many, many people out there who have an intense phobia of driving across high bridges over open water.
Number 1. Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge. This is it, the granddaddy of them all. The massive bridge tunnel system connects three major cities on the edge of the South China Sea, the most heavily used piece of ocean for shipping and transport in the world. The total cost? $19 billion. The total length? 34 miles, or 55 kilometers. This is like the Chesapeake Bay Bridge's older brother. The whole project took 10 years to complete and only recently opened. 19 workers lost their lives on this massive engineering feat, which contains four artificial islands to help hold the whole system together. The first part is the main bridge, which crosses the span of the river for over 14 miles and is attached on artificial islands to the Hong Kong Link Road in the east and the Zhuhai Link Road in the west.
The whole system is a marvel of engineering.
It was designed to last for at least 120 years and is a major artery in traffic between these centers of commerce at the end of the Pearl River in southern China. The travel benefits are immense, cutting the travel time from Hong Kong to Macau from 4 hours to half an hour. China is hoping to create a new economic powerhouse among these cities.